Hello everybody, welcome to the Java course. Java is a really versatile language. It is commonly used in many applications. It is also a quite fundamental language. When you are able to master Java, you can master many other computer languages. Java is also a portable language in that when you complete your code in one operating system, you can use the code proof created in that operating system to other operating systems. So it is really convenient for cross-platform applications. For installing Java into your machine, I will show you some tips to you. I'm using Linux Ubuntu distribution, so I would suggest OpenJDK. For OpenJDK, you can follow the link here to install the Java Development Kit. When I click on that link, I can see the commands required to install different versions of the Java Development Kit on different distributions. In fact, I have a better way of doing so. I can use the terminal. By using this command, I can install the default JDK provided by the Ubuntu repository. Press Y and wait. Okay, now Java JDK is installed for me already. I can check the version installed for me by using this command. Java space hyphen version. When I click enter, I can see that Java 11 is installed for me. If you are using other operating systems, you can still install Java Development Kit. I would suggest you to go to the adopt-openjdk.net website. On this website, you can choose other platforms. And then you can choose the OpenJDK version you would like to use. And for the JVM, you can choose hotspot. And then you can click on the appropriate operating system you are going to use. And then you can download the installation files for other operating systems. After you installing Java into your computer, I'm going to install the interactive development environment. For Java, I would like to use Eclipse IDE. It is a completely free IDE for Java developers. It is also pretty versatile and it is fully functional. If I'm using Ubuntu, I don't need to go to the eclipse.org web page. What I want to do is this. I go to the Ubuntu software. Yes, I can simply type Eclipse and then Eclipse will come up. And then I click on install. Okay, Eclipse is now installed already. If you are using other operating systems, you can install Eclipse by using these download links for your operating systems. Now let me open Eclipse in my computer. I simply click launch. Okay, I can use the default path for my workspace. Launch. Okay, Eclipse workspace is already opened. I can enlarge it. This is the welcome screen. And we can click on the restore button to show the default environment. And this completes the installation of the Eclipse IDE for Java. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.